Hold on to what you've heard. Hold on to what you have heard.
So I would like to take this opportunity to encourage us to recollect all the prophetic words that we ever got, all of them, and we organize them in two categories, like the one that have already been fulfilled in our lives and the one that are yet to be fulfilled. In the first category, the one that have already been fulfilled, it will help you activate your faith. Anything that the Lord has spoken to you beforehand and you saw it being fulfilled before your eyes, it will give you faith to know that the one that are yet to be fulfilled, you certainly be fulfilled, because the Lord has released His word and He said that His word will not return to Him void. We need to acquire wisdom and knowledge, no matter the cost. Invest time and money in big seminars, meetings, trainings, even for our children. However, I would like to kind of draw our attention to this, and that this word is spoken directly from the Lord. It's Matthew chapter 7, verse 24, where the Lord says, "Therefore, everyone who hears this word of mine and acts on them will be like a sensible man who builds his house on rocks." There are two things. You, first of all, you hear the word of God, you receive the prophetic word, however way it came to you, whether it's when you were reading the word, whether it was delivered to you by a servant of God, a minister of God, or it was an inspiration of the Holy Spirit directly into your ears or in your heart. You, first of all, you hear them. And the second thing is to act on them, so that you will be like a sensible man. The Bible says that faith comes from what you hear. You hear the word of the Lord and then you act on them. As you act on them, you're actually demonstrating your faith. Your faith must be logical, rational, sound, balanced, pragmatic. And the Lord desires us to have an empirical evidence of who He is and what He can do. But that's what it means by being sensible. When you put in action the word of God that you receive, you are being a wise person. Remember, we receive the word that we need to acquire wisdom. So one of the ways to acquire wisdom is to act upon the word of the Lord that we receive. You can have a bunch of money, but you're not even given an opportunity to buy, first of all, to buy a house, right? Maybe because your credit score is not that great, despite the fact that you may have a lot of money in the bank. Maybe, you know, something else is going on and you're not in a position. Maybe you have that money, but you're in jail. How are you going to go ahead and buy the house, right? So there are things, certain things that you have to be able to do in order for that word to come to pass into your life. So as we collect all those things, again, put them into categories, the one that have been fulfilled and the one that have yet to be fulfilled. And the third category will be, what are the things that I need to do for that word to be fulfilled in my life? Because remember, there are the things that the Lord does and there are the things that we do. And God has set up our relationship so that we work in collaboration with Him, right? So we work hand in hand with Him. We work by the Spirit. We act by the Spirit. So we are led by the Spirit. So there are things that the Lord does and there are things that we do in our part. We have to do our part. The reality of your God, the reality of heaven, the reality of who the Lord Jesus is should be more tangible than the present difficulties of obstacles or, you know, or hurdles that you may be facing at this moment, if you are facing anything. We need to get to that point where whatever you have heard, whatever it is that you've heard, hold on to it, because it will surely come to pass. God is faithful. God is faithful. The Bible says that the one who receives the word of God and doesn't practice it, doesn't work on it, doesn't obey it, is not doing a good work. However, blessing is the portion of the doer of the word. So as you hear the word of God, as you receive it, and as you act upon it, you are blessed in what you do. And you are blessed because you are doing what the Lord has proclaimed will come to pass in your life. You are blessed in what you do. Amen. Say after me, I do what God tells me and I am blessed in what I do. May that be your portion. The Lord is providing peace that surpasses all understanding, that His peace will guard our heart. In the midst of trial, may the peace of God keep your heart. In the midst of obstacles, may the peace of God keep your heart. In the midst of a setback, may the peace of God keep your heart. In the midst of disappointment, may the peace of God keep your heart. In the midst of a delay, may the peace of God keep your heart. And you're expecting something, maybe a trial to end, but it doesn't end. You're expecting a bad season to end, but it hasn't ended yet, but you endure until the end. And the Lord says, the one who keeps my works to the end. The Bible says that God has prepared good works beforehand so that we may practice them. So if we keep practicing those good works, and as we said before, the good work that we're doing is to put in practice what the Lord has said. Whatever you have heard the Lord say about yourself, about your family, about your ministry, about your work, about your friends, if you keep the work on it, you act on it, you are practicing the good work of the Lord. If you are practicing it, if you are victorious and you keep working on those things until the end without giving up, He will give you authority over the nation, and you will be able to shepherd them with an iron scepter. He will also give you the morning star that He has received from His Father. So two things to remember. We have received a word during our prayer meeting. One of those words was to acquire wisdom by all means. And one of the ways to acquire wisdom is by acting on the word that we have heard. We are being like a sensible man, a thoughtful man, a wise man, a commonsensical man, a pragmatical man. That's what it means. And we are guaranteed there are rewards attached to that obedience, blessings in what we're doing, authority over the nation, and the morning star, that is, in the life to come. Amen? Blessings in what we're doing, that is the present tense. It's not in the future. It's right now. Blessings in whatever you're doing. Whatever you're doing, if you're working, are putting into practice what you have heard, what you have endured, even if you have received a word 10 years ago, 15 years ago, God is not held by time. So whatever it is that you have received, even if it's been 25 years ago and it has not yet come to pass, endure, keep on it, keep working on it, and it shall definitely come to pass.